Yeah, back on the SportsMax Zone, let's return to cricket. The West Indies four-day championship got underway today with four matches taking place simultaneously in St. Kitts and Nevis and Jamaica. Remember, no play in the game between the combined campuses and colleges and Barbados Pride scheduled for Chedwin Park because of a wet outfield. Now, let's go to St. Kitts and Nevis at Stumps at Connery Cricket Ground. Trinidad and Tobago Red Force, after winning the toss and electing to bat, reached 215 for four before bad light stopped play. The first century of the competition coming from Jason Mohammed, not out on 100, 227 deliveries. He struck 11 fours, hasn't hit a six yet, and he got good support from Tion Webster, who scored a half century, 50. Meanwhile, at Stumps on day one in the other game in St. Kitts at Warner Park, the Leeward Islands Hurricanes were bowled out for 137 after being sent to bat by the West Indies Academy, who at Stumps are 70 for two. They are trailing by some 77 runs. Jeremiah Lewis top scored for the Hurricanes with 45. Joshua James, 3 for 11. Ashmead Ned, the left-arm spinner, 2 for 3. And the West Indies Academy being led at the moment by Becky Joseph with an unbeaten 30. Akeem Ogiest unbeaten on 15 at the close. A wicket for Colin Archibald and Louis. Archibald 1 for 3. Louis 1 for 12. So the first century of the Cricket West Indies four-day championship coming today lands from one of the veterans, Jason Mohammed.
Yeah, 37 years old now, former West Indies under 19 captain Jason Mohammed. Good to see him still getting among the runs.
And Trinidad and Tobago, the Red Force team suffering from a drought, Ricardo, in regional, well, red ball titles.
They haven't
won a red ball title since 2006. And during that period, we've seen Guyana win six titles. Jamaica and Barbados, I think, each have won about five or so during that period. So T&T Red Force really overdue for a title in four-day cricket. And a little hard to understand because they have produced good cricketers consistently for decades, Trinidad and Tobago. So it's a little curious that they haven't won a red ball title since 2006.
Yeah, you said they have produced good cricketers, but a lot of those have swayed towards the limited over versions of the game. And I think that's part of the reason why when I looked at the Trinidad and Tobago Red Force lineup, I was quite pleased to see the name Jaden Seals, because there was doubt about whether he would be fit in time to start the competition. He is fit. He has started. Of course, Trinidad and Tobago batting first, so no need for him to bowl today. But I can't wait to see what he offers with the ball.
Yeah, and especially since we have seen Shamar Joseph rise up as a genuine, solid new ball bowler. Jaden Seals, because of his pace, a lot of West Indies cricket fans are anticipating that he would be a good new ball partner when fit for Shamar Joseph. So what he does here in this regional four-day tournament, Jaden Seals, will be closely watched.
Yeah, interesting matchup as well for the Guyana Harpy Eagles, Kevin Sinclair and Vera Samipamol in the lineup. Vera Samipamol, one of the most consistent bowlers in regional cricket, pretty much almost every season. He leads wicket taking 2 for 40 to start the competition. Kevin Sinclair, none for 57 from his 24 overs. But of course, Kevin Sinclair, the one who is in the West Indies setup at the moment. And I think we can safely say that we will not see Vera Samipamol again at West Indies level. But at the regional level, he continues to do really well.
Yeah, Guyana has had a tradition of producing pretty outstanding spinners. And in the past decade, we've seen that continue. Devendra Bishu and Vera Samipamol for many, many years dominated regional cricket with the ball.
And before them, Neil McGarland, Mahendra Nagamutu.
Yeah, you know, that has been so, of course. Lance Gibbs had set the stage from the 60s and so on. So good to see the Guyana Harpy Eagles coming out to defend their title. I put it to Akeem Jordan and Zachary McCaskey yesterday when they were on the show if they thought Guyana Harpy Eagles would be as potent with Kevlon Anderson as their captain and not Leon Johnson, who was widely regarded, Ricardo, as one of the most astute captains in regional cricket for the past decade, and the results showed.
Yeah, very much the case. Also, the other game that we had played was at Sabina Park in Kingston, the Jamaica Scorpions taking on the Windward Islands Volcanoes, and the Scorpions bonded out for 159. Romain Morris stopped scoring in that match with 35. He was unfortunate to run out. We do have Gerard Morris-Seeley on location at Sabina Park, and let's get the latest from him. Gerard?
Thank you so much, Ricardo. And yeah, I'm here at Sabina Park, and at the close of play score, let me give you that firstly. Windward Island Volcanoes 157 for 2 after 41 overs. Of course, play was being extended for a couple overs after there was a very slow over rate by both teams. So that's why we went over to 5:30, while all the other games finished at 5 o'clock. But yeah, at the end of play, we had Kimani Melius. He was on 31, of course. Rather, Johan Jeremiah not out on 66. Sunil Ambrose on 30 not out after 41 overs. Windward Islands Volcanoes on 2 runs behind Jamaica Scorpions. So there are one innings here completed. Jamaica batting first. It was a horrible day for them, struggling with bat and ball. They were skittled out for 159, 74 for 5 after the first session. And then there was a mini partnership between Romain Morris and Abhijay Mansingh. But unfortunately, as you mentioned, Ricardo, Morris was run out, and then Mansingh was out. Well, he was out very shortly after Morris, and that slump right down to 157. So if it wasn't for the final three batsmen, they would not have made it to 150 runs, because it looked like they would have been bowled up for 120 by the early tea break, but they managed to get to 157 runs. It was a really good start from Kimani Melius for the Windward Islands Volcanoes. He got 31 before he was out, and then significantly slowing down the scoring rate for the Windward Islands Volcanoes. But then they picked up through Jeremiah, and then I got a couple of runs at the end, and that's why they are 2 runs behind now. We thought they would have been able to take the lead before the end of play, but they weren't able to do so. Some really good bowling by Jermaine Blackwood was able to tie them down. Salmon at the end was able to tie them down a bit as well. And only the spinners were able to get the 2 wickets for the Jamaica Scorpions. And then they continue here tomorrow. They will hope that they can replay and regroup and get something productive out of day 2, because it was a really horrible day for Jamaica, a really tough day for Jamaica, and they can do better. They know that they can do better, and they would want to regroup and come back stronger on day 2. While the Windward Islands Volcanoes will be hoping that Jeremiah can follow suit with Jason Mohammed and score 100 for this tournament, and yeah, they would really need it from Volcanoes, and really need it from Jeremiah rather, and yeah, it'll be really good to see them go on a day 2 and take a significant lead against the Scorpions.
Yeah, thanks very much, Gerard, live from Sabina Park on day 1 of the first round of the Cricket West Indies 4-day championship. The Windward Islands Volcanoes very much in charge of that encounter, 2 runs behind, but they have 8 first innings wickets in hand. They dominated the opening day, and surely Kimani Melius and his team very much pleased with their performance. Let's take a break on the SportsMax Zone. We'll close out today's action with Interactive.